Okay, let's take a closer look at the mirror monitor. When it gets the ignition from the vehicle, it will boot up. It's basically a mini computer based on the Android ecosystem. If you put the vehicle into reverse during the boot up process, it will immediately come on and show you what's on behind the vehicle. It doesn't need the ecosystem to be running before you want to use the reverse. So you can come in and out any time during that process, and then obviously you'll start driving and the system will then finalize its booting up process. Once it's booted up, you'll get a screen on there that will show you the date, the time, and the various Android apps that allow you to quickly go into certain areas. So we've got navigation, DVR, there's a front camera on the front of this to record what's happening on the road ahead, Bluetooth hands-free phone kit, then your app area, your settings area, scroll over, you've got your files, your music. This is FMT, is designed to send the audio from this unit down to your stereo system through an FM modulator, pictures, and then GPS info. For instance, GPS info will show you here what satellites you're picking up. The more satellites, the better. That gives you better accuracy for navigation on there. So if we come out of this screen and we go back into the main screen and then we scroll across, the first thing you notice is navigation. So we can go into navigation and this will load up Google Maps, which is the default nav. This is linked via your phone, so it takes the data from your phone to get the data onto here. You'll see that we're clearly shown where we are on the screen, and then we can go into the appropriate navigation. So we can go up to search, for instance, and we can decide what we want to do. We can start driving, go into timelines. We can choose predefined areas, traffic information, so it will show us what the traffic is in the local area. So at the moment we've got light traffic information. Do we want real-time traffic information without turn-by-turn directions? So you can just have standard traffic information, for instance, as you're driving, so you can see what's ahead of you. We can obviously add our home address and our work address. We can choose where we want to go. So this is setting itself up now to do a navigation run. So we know where we are. We can set a destination on there the usual way. For instance, we could choose a restaurant and then it will go down, look for various restaurants around the area that you might want to go. So if we want fish and chips or something like that, you can click on the fish hut and then it will sort out the driving directions and then press
navigate. On your way to fish hut, there's the usual traffic. The route via A511 is the fastest.
So we get the choice there immediately of what we want to do, and then it'll start navigating us if we want to go. If we come out of this screen, we've got a return button that allows us to come out of the screens, and ultimately we want to go right back to the main screen, and then we can see the other applications on the camera. DVR, that shows you what's happening on the road ahead. You get the usual features of a DVR. You can change the settings, you can play back the video files and everything else. Gives an excellent picture of what's going on in front of the vehicle. Great in times of an accident or somewhere where someone's done something in front of you and you want to prove that it was nothing to do with you. Again, Bluetooth, that allows you to connect your phone to the system so you can receive and send calls through the mirror monitor itself. It's got a built-in speaker, as you've heard. It's also got built-in microphones. We've got App Store. This allows us to load our various apps that you might want to do. You can also get apps off Play Store, for instance. One of the apps I've put on here is for speed camera detection, so while you're driving down the road you'll get warned about speed cameras. You can play YouTube. Main settings menu, this allows you to do the brightness, what your location information, dateful time changes and so on. There's other application settings within there that takes you in, so you can log on to Bluetooth and Wi-Fi. It doesn't get much simpler than this. It's dead easy to install, very secure on the way it works. The DVR offers full 1080p video and the navigation is available by Google Maps. You can load other navigation apps on if you have a preference for someone else. Google is probably one of the best. It's the most up-to-date nav systems available on the market. When you turn the ignition off, the unit just disappears, turns itself off, and looks like a normal mirror for all intents and purposes. So it's now shutting down, and that's it.